out here on Lake Blackshear in Cordele, Georgia. I'm about 2.5 hours southwest of the Atlanta area, and I have been here for 2 days. But the reason why I wanted to create this vlog, it's not to share my trip like I thought I was. This time I am going to talk about a very, very great figure, even though I've never read any of his theories. And I'd like to dedicate this video to Mr. Stephen Hawking. And I wanted to put a few notes out there about that. So yesterday morning I was getting up, drinking a cup of coffee, watching ABC Morning News, ABC Morning News, and I was about to jump in the shower when I saw some video footage of Mr. Stephen Hawking, and at first I thought that they were talking about something else that he discovered, and then something inside just showed. I mean, I asked myself in my head, wait, did he just die? And so I sat there and listened, and sure enough, that he had passed away. So I learned what was also interesting is that he passed away on Albert Einstein's birthday and National Pie Day, which, not like a piece of a pie or a whole pie, like, no, but the Greek symbol pi, P-I, and the first three letters, or the first three digits in a pi is 3.14, and yesterday was 3.14 in March. So that was really interesting. But one of the things that I tended to forget about, and those at work, I'm sure, is that Stephen Hawking would have been an individual with a disability, but I think what made Hawking so fascinating is, yes, he was completely immobile from his ALS. I forget what the A part stands for, but I call it Lou Gehrig's disease. And the fact that there are people that took an ice bucket challenge 4 years ago trying to find a cure for ALS. And the fact that we focused on his mind and the fact that he had come up with all of these great theories. Now, I found out that Stephen Hawking said something very similar to what Dr. Temple Grandin told me when I met her in 2014, and that was to focus on what you can do and get away from what you can't do. And do what you can. And my whole thing with Stephen Hawking is, you know, after seeing him and learning that he passed away, and I would like to say this for those of you who are inside the autistic community, do not ever give up. Just because you have sensory problems, and just because you read social cues, or just because you have meltdowns and panic attacks, whatever those are, don't ever give up. And again, focus on what you can do and work around what you can't, and just build up on your strengths. I mean, in my case, I have a colleague of mine who I share an office with, and she has skills in transcribing different focus groups and research projects. That's a skill that I'll never be able to do because I have a very short attention span. But I'm better at collecting data, putting it into an Excel spreadsheet, and most likely learning how to calculate that data. Sure, I may never be able to read other people's social cues. I may never be able to like certain types of touching, certain types of food, but that doesn't mean I can't live a self-fulfilling life. And one of the things that's inspiring about Hawking is that, yes, he got sick, he got ALS, lost all functions in motor skills, just walking, moving your hands, moving your mouth, being able to speak the way that I can, but his brain was able to function and he was able to use another part of his brain. So today, let's remember the great Stephen Hawking, and let's remember, don't ever give up. Let's remember that even for those of you that are unemployed and you have great skills, whether you're writing something, or you've got brilliant artwork, or you're sitting around learning everything on your own on physics, don't ever give up. Just because somebody says that you can't do something, don't listen to that. Listen to yourself. Look at all the things that you've been able to do in the past and focus on those. And find people that are going to listen to you and invest your time in them, because those other negative people, they're making assumptions about you and when they really don't know squat. And you know what? Those doctors that said that Stephen Hawking wouldn't live past a certain age, those are just assumptions. Just remember who you are. Remember what you're good at and get to know yourself as much as possible. And stand up for what you believe in. Believe in yourself. I'm out of time for today. I hope you enjoyed this beautiful scenery of the Cordell and Lake Blackshear area. Until next time, I'm Maya Sendermeyer, and I'm signing off.